I'm Tobias, one of the Android developer at Nextcloud, and I want to show you what we did last year and what is about the next upcoming release. So from the last conference to this conference, we did draw 9 stable releases and 8 release candidates. And as you can see, the commit history is quite as active as the last year. We also managed to double the active installations. Active installations are those installations that are signed in within the last 7 days via Gplay. So I guess this is quite impressive for an open source system. Under the hood, we changed the release cycle to have a more reliable time schedule. So we aim to release every 2 months a new release, which with 6 weeks of developing, then afterwards 2 weeks of stabilizing phase. So we are just doing a feature freeze, then doing a public release on Play Store and F-Droid, and give it out in the wild to see if there are some bugs, and of course we are fixing them, and after this we release it again on Play Store and F-Droid. In between, we can now, because we have managed or changed the system, we can now release bug fixes. They are on demand if we have a pull request or a fix which is worth of backporting, so we can create a new stable release from the branch, for example, 3.2, while already developing the next upcoming version of 3.3. And so we just have smaller releases, which are easier to test and have not so many impacts for changing for the users. And we can therefore have interim bug fix and new versions. This is the time schedule, and as you can see, the last 3.x versions have roughly amount the same time span. The current one is a little bit delayed because of the company, because we want to integrate single sign-on, and after the conference there will be in the next week the RC1 for the upcoming version. Also, we wanted to have a more awareness of our code quality, so we integrated our test system in Tron, with unit and test integrations. And so you find in every pull request a summary with find bugs, lint, PMD, and code coverage. On the right side, you can see the amount of changes of code coverage and how many find bugs warnings there are. And our aim is to reduce them, or at most do not have more than before in terms of warnings or errors. So our next upcoming version will include those main features. The now well-known feature is Trashbin. It is for Nextcloud 14 only. You can either revert or undelete those files and folders, or you can also empty the complete Trashbin via the mobile phone. In the file detail view, you can see the file versioning and restore any version you like. And a long-term wished feature is the video streaming. So if you have a big video or a big audio file, you don't have to prior download the whole file to watch it, but you can just stream it with our internal player. So the default is when you are clicking on the file, you're just streaming it instead of downloading it, or you can open it with an external app like VLC or any other preferred audio or video player. And under the hood, this is done by a secure link, so no credentials are exposed. And the next big change will be that we have no available offline folders or files anymore. Previously, you had to choose a file that you want to keep available offline so that every change is automatically synced. This led to the problem that there were sometimes downloaded files, which are regular downloaded files, but then are out of sync, and so you have opened the old version. And now we are just checking if you are on the Wi-Fi, and every 2 hours then all downloaded files will automatically get synced. And if you are not on the Wi-Fi, you will see on the folder entry the outdated downloaded files and can then manually choose to download them. And as also was said by Stefan, the last but in my opinion one of the main major biggest features since And Alexa.1.0 is singleton on, and this is a talk by David.